This is the part 5 of modeling a spatial relationships video, and in this part we will discuss about the geographically weighted regression. And here, this is something about me. I'm Dr. Zubairul Islam. I'm working in the Department of Geography at Gujarat University. So the ArcMap is open, and we have the data, and this is the result of our last previous exercise of OLS. And now in this exercise, we will practice geographically weighted regression. So I didn't delete this data because it will help us to compare the difference in between OLS, and it will help us to explain the geographically weighted regression also. So let's see. Let me close it, and I will open the geographical weighted regression here. And again, we have to give our data. I'm giving the same data here, and the dependent variable, I will take the same GDP data of 2015, and explanatory variables also I will take the same here. GDP, I'm taking the built up area, population, one is population, and second I'm taking the built up area 2015. And here we can see the kernel type, by default it is fixed, and band width method. Here there are three options: AIC, CV, and bandwidth parameters. So if you are choosing AICC, then the extent of the kernel is determined using the ACAIC information criteria, that is in short AICs. And if you are choosing the CV, then the extent of the kernel is determined using the cross validation. And if you are using the bandwidth parameter, so in this case the extent of the kernel is determined by the fixed distance or a fixed number of the neighbors. Suppose here, if you take the bandwidth parameter like this here, then you have to give the distance, that which distance is important for you. Means it may be 20 kilometer, 40 kilometer, 60 kilometer, based on the type of the data you think. So here in this case, when we are giving the bandwidth method, what does it indicate? It indicates actually there is a difference from OLS in GWR. In GWR, this is also one of the, you know, several spatial regression techniques increasingly used in geography and another discipline. This geographical weighted regression provides a local model of the variable or process you are trying to understand or predict by fitting a regression equation to every feature in the data set. Actually, GWR, that is geographical weighted regression, it constructs the separate equation by incorporating the dependent and explanatory variables of features falling within the bandwidth of each target feature. So the shape and size of the bandwidth is depend on the user input for the kernel type, bandwidth method, distance, and number of neighbors parameters. So this geographical weighted regression means here, when the result will be there, then it will be clear to us that each feature will have its own equation. I mean, the each within the this within the distance, or means within the neighbors, given neighbors, means the equation will be the separated, and it will have its own the coefficients. So it will help us, means when the result will there, it will be clear to us. So let's make it okay. I am doing it here with AICC. Okay, then do it. Okay, so this is the result, and now we can see more or less visibility is same only. but it is not 100% same. There is a difference. This is geographical weighted regression, and here this is ordinary least square method. So here, if you will see that North Gondar color has changed, Awi color has changed, and Asosa has come to the middle part of the deviation. And the major change which we can see here, this Addis Ababa has got a different color. It is showing that let's see here the results open attribute table, and when we see, these are the observed GDPs here. I think this is here highest Addis Ababa. So in observed and predicted, now there is a difference when we are using geographical weighted regression. And we can see here standard residual is 1.7. What does it mean? That what it is observed means GDP is higher, means in the prediction GDP is less, but in actual it is higher in relation with population and built up area. So now this is the change, and we can see here for each zone there is a coefficient intercept, and there is a coefficient for population here 433, and this is for coefficient for built up area here. So the general idea we can get, if coefficient is less means it's better if coefficient is less, and it is it shows the better relationship in between dependent and independent variable. Okay, so you can do, you can use your data, and you can use this special relationships, and thereafter you can for another results you can go to the geoprocessing and results, and this is geographical weighted regression here, and this is the message. In the message you can see what is the sigma, what is the R square here. R square is 0.84. What does it mean? That variability in the GDP and data is being explained by the population and built up data, means 84% variability is being explained by these two explanatory variables, which are the population and built up area. So this is all about the geographical weighted regression, and there may be something which is not clear to you, so you can write in the comment box and I will try to answer that questions of you. And it's enough for now. Thank you for listening, and thanks for watching. Thank you very much.